more blessed. I'm saying different roles. Right? You know, different roles. Iba lang yung role nila, iba yung role natin. Our role somehow is, if we are the giver, then praise God. Amen. And I'm not saying that we are more blessed because we are the giver and they're less blessed because they're the receiver. No, it's just how the system works. It is just the to put it in order in proper roles. See to it that we do our role, right? Huh? So we need 2,300 actually. Medyo tumabingi yung bangka when we had the school supplies. Kasi yung mga nag-pledge sa school supplies, nalimutan naman mag-pledge sa missions. Kaya munting nang tumunog yung lata ng ano. May kasabihin sa Tagalog eh, kapag magsahin ka, inilagay ng bigas lata. Pag it's hard for me to speak in Tagalog naman, guys. Kapag gumanon na, tapos kapag tumunog yung lata, ay, ala na pong bigas. Tumunog yung lata last month sa ating missions account. Matagal akong hindi tinext ni Nancy. Kasi ala na pala siyang ipapadala. So silent siya. But praise God, we are able to manage, we're able still to provide. So, please, yung ating mga monthly mission pledgers, continue. Some of you are giving $20, $50, $100. Some are giving $200. Hindi na po namin yan palaging binabanggit na, oh, magbigay kayo. Because we know you are mature enough and responsible enough that kahit po kasi magbigay kayo o hindi, we still need to give this amount to them. You know? Now, saksi si Pastor Joe. Si Pastor Jun po, sabihan itong ating mga, ano to, gano'n na lang. Sabihin lang, oh, huwag kayong umasa na kung magaling sa Amerika eh. No. Talagang we see that they work, they serve God. Now, sa paglilingkod nila, huwag na sana nilang problemahin kung ano pa yung kakainin nila. O kung ano pa yung ipapamasahin nila pagpunta doon sa bundok. No, that's our part. That's our role. Right? Huh? Amen? Yeah. To support these pastors. May mga pamilya rin sila. May mga anak din sila. Am I more blessed because of mga... No. Is Pastor John more blessed because we're hearing him? No. Different roles lang. Magkakaiba lang ng lugar. Pero iisa naman Diyos natin. Iisang pananampalataya natin. Right? Now, if you want to increase your pledge, praise God. That's good. Because we don't want to confine ourselves to what we have now. Ang kulang ng missions is not missionaries. Ang kulang ng missions, resources. Believe me. Resources. Every time we meet, pastoral meeting nila, Pastor Alex, oh, Pastor Alex, pwede ba tayong magganyan sa Davao, magganyan sa Davao? Isa lang naman ang palagi niya sinasabi. Madali lang naman yan. Ano yung na dyan? Ay, venue. Sabi ni Alex, madali lang naman yan. Pwede naman natin lahat gawin yan kung meron lang tayong resources. You know? So, if you feel in your heart that you want to increase your pledge, do it every month, $20. Mga estudyante, meron pang $5. Eh. You know, yung ibang estudyante dyan, $10. Yung mga gumraduate ng estudyante at nagtatrabaho na, increase nyo na. Huh? Increase nyo na, gawin nyo ng 25. Okay? Kung dati 5. Kasi Pastor Noli, grabe. It's okay. Ano? I don't have to explain myself. I don't have to explain what we do. Hello? Hindi ko naman sinasabi ito para ibigay natin sa kay Pastor Jude, Pastor Alex, or me. No. Kita niyo naman yung... You know, this is what I'm really proud about. Not really proud in negative way. But I'm really proud about our missions. Hindi ito, walang hanky-panky po dito.
Amen.
Talagang direct tayo. Kita niyo, ang budget natin kay Pastor Nolan is only what, ilan? Hindi, ilang mo dapat? 150? He stretched it to 300! Instead of buying shoes, kasi nga naman sa mga bundok, mas importante sinelas. Kasi bakit? Pag lalakad sa putik, tatanggalin ang sinelas ng papaan. No, no, true. You know? Eh pag nakasapatos, edi ano yung sapatos, tsaka lalaban pa, mas okay sa kanila sinelas. So sinelas ang binili ni Pastor Nolan, mas mura, dumami.
Amen.
You know? So, I'm so blessed that number one, we have a legitimate mission. Number two, we are partnered with people who are not hirelings, but really has a heart to serve God. Pastor Nolan, Pastor Boyet, the staff in Davao. You know, so let's start it ngayon. If you want to put it in writing, I don't know. John, ano ba yung natin sa pledges na yan? And I like this. I like to be open to you. Thank God. You know, we have an avenue sa ating missions where some of the amount of money that some of you give can be doubled kasi merong matching yung kanilang company. Ano yung matching? In Tagalog, in Guru. Na nagmamatch. Those who are employed in bigger companies, their company match what they give. You know? So, there are some of you that your company matches it. Kaya medyo tumataas yung ating missions funds. So, again, I am knocking at the generous doors of your heart. Don't make it lower. If you want to make it bigger, please. And it is on a monthly. We hope to collect it. Now, if you can, ang target natin to collect it every second Sunday. But if okay lang kahit kailan yung ibigay, basta within that month. Okay, pledging $20. Okay. Just put it on writing that that's your pledge, aside from your tithes. And the first commandment of tithing, kapag tithes, tithes. Kapag pledge, pledge. Magkano ba tithes na? Okay, 100. Okay, 8 niya lang muna sa tithes, 20 niya sa. No, 100 pa rin yung tithes. Because that is the whole tithe. Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse. Whole. Tapos na yung ating blue light special, wala nang 5% sa tithes. 10 na talaga yan. Now, because there was a joke, right? That in order for your church to grow, teach tithing not 10% but 5%. Para lang daw lumami pa. We don't do that. So, yung pledge, yung tithes. Okay, so let's be obedient to that. And Pastor John?
God is real, amen?
Amen!
Salamat po sa Diyos, sapagkat siya lamang talaga ang pinagadarihan ng aking provisions. At to God be the glory po sa lahat ng tao, bata, malanda, na pinapasaya natin doon sa lugar na yun. And faith without works is dead, sabi nga po sa Bible. So, we are the one that has faith with action. And of course, surely enough that God will always overtake the mga pagkapala na pinatulaw natin sa kanila, kapalit po nila sa atin. Amen? As I was in the Philippines, I just want to give you a little bit of heads of how God is really putting us into a place that where we are right now, very comfortable. You just go to work, drive a good car in a nice freeway. But in the Philippines, those people that are there are really not giving, not enjoying what we are enjoying here. And that's one of our benefits, being obedient to God. Amen? Amen. Our environment is very, very, masyado pong maano na, mainit. Respiring, ang traffic is really amazing for extreme 4 hours before you can go to one point to another point. So having said that, I think we are in the right place and the right time and on the right guy that we are worshiping today. So with His fullness and His grace, sa ating mga buhay, I think we have no more remorse to what to give and to share our blessings to others, especially to what you have seen in our videos, in Facebook, in everything that we do. Kaya, one more time, we're knocking at the door of each one of our hearts today, that the Lord said that if you give and if you reach to the least member of my people, then you are doing it to me.
Amen.
At this point in time, we just want to give back to all the glory to God, that we are so blessed that we are being used by the Lord to do the task. And surely enough that, like, in 3 years now, it's been 3 years only. But how much more when we go to like 5 or 10 or more years? We're building people.
Amen.
Of different, with different things that they may have in the future. And because of our heart's desire to give, we are moving them to a different level of hope, of life standard. And we just thank God that we're part of it. Amen?
Amen.
Let's pray. Let's bow our hearts to God and let's be thankful that we are gathered one more time in this place, knowing and believing that without God in our hearts, we can do nothing. Lord, we just praise you and just thank you for this time that we have connected our spirit, our hearts into you. We thank you that you have honored all our gift, all our effort, that our love for you will never be lost because of your love to us. We thank you for today that we were able to give what we have, we can able to share the things that we have in our lives. We also thank you. Bless all the people that receives our blessings, or the blessings that we have shared, and those that are here right now, Lord, bless them. Bless the giver and the gift, that we will use this gift for the propagations of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Today, but rather I have a plea. Next week is Father's Day. So, what's that? It's a plea, please do something on Father's Day. Right, so I will be through Hope Group, and then Sister Maggie will be coordinating with the madam next week. Right? So please, have prepared something for us. Thank you.
Ano daw yun? Next week ka, Father's Day. Kumatid kayo, ha? Please. Please attend church. It's Father's Day.
What do you have for us?
We also like to welcome JJ. Jesse. Jesse.
Pinababalik yan. May kain na ba tayo sa Father's Day? Bahala na po kayo. It's up to you. Joy, let's stand and let's close us in prayer. Thank you, Lord. We're good?
Amen.
Your presence today, Lord God, and thank you for your message about the third commandment, Lord God. Lord, may this message dwell in our hearts, Lord God, and may it bring fresh conviction to our hearts whenever we misuse your name, Lord God. May our lips, Lord God, bring praises to you and give honor to your name, Lord God. And as we depart from this place, Lord God, we ask you to protect us and guide us throughout the remainder of the week. This we ask in the mighty name of Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen. bless you. Sister Ida is here. Sister Ida, we love you so much. Your family is behind you. We love you. God bless you. Have a blessed day, everyone.